Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I want to introduce you to Microsoft Fabric. You may be new to Microsoft Fabric altogether, or you may be coming from Power BI and wondering, what is Microsoft Fabric? I want to know more. Microsoft Fabric is a cloud service. So it's a platform, it's a software as a service or a SaaS product, you may hear that word. And what it does is bring together a lot of different services that have been out there for a while into one spot. So think of this, one lake when we think about lake houses, one security when we think about managing items and data, row level security, those type of items, one way to discover data, one way to manage your data and govern. These are all items inside of Microsoft Fabric. And so before we had just Power BI, and the Power BI service itself was very full featured from a platform perspective. We had workspaces, we had capacities, we had all of these items. And now what Microsoft is doing is leveraging that platform and expanding it for other workloads. You may have been familiar with or have heard things like Azure Data Factory, Azure Synapse Analytics. These items have been retooled and taken to the next level inside of Microsoft Fabric. There are 7 workloads that are defined as part of Microsoft Fabric. So we've got Data Factory, we've got Synapse Data Engineering, we have Synapse Data Science, Synapse Data Warehouse, Synapse Real-Time Analytics, Power BI, and the new Data Activator, which isn't currently available as of the time of this recording, but it will be coming to Microsoft Fabric soon. It was demoed at the Microsoft Build conference where this was all announced. And so if you're coming from Power BI, this should be very familiar. The UI itself should be very familiar to you, and the concept of workspaces and capacities and how we actually create items inside of the service itself. For those that are coming from either Data Factory and or Azure Synapse Analytics, this will be a new experience for you as this is a SaaS service, right? So it's almost like a turnkey type item. You don't have to go provision things. They're just available for you, backed by capacity. That was the challenge before Microsoft Fabric, where you had all of these different services and you had to wire them up. It was very complicated to actually get going. You may have been an expert in Azure Synapse Analytics and or like a data warehouse or a database, but you didn't necessarily know how to use Data Factory or pipelining or those type of things. And or you may be coming from data science and it was really hard to get your data. What did you have access to? Where was it actually located? How do you go talk to the people that can get you what you need so you can do your job? Even on the Power BI side, sometimes this was a challenge in terms of getting to a database or trying to stand up a database or a data warehouse of some kind and working with lake data. I keep hearing about this lake concept, but where is the lake and how do I get access to it? That's where Microsoft Fabric really comes in, and the beauty and the power of Microsoft Fabric. It is lake-centric, and so one lake is the underpinning of all of this. One lake allows for the storage of Parquet Delta files. Microsoft Fabric has been standardized on that. As a result of that, with compression and additional work that Microsoft did to leverage some of the technologies that have been used in Power BI to make this even faster with better compression, I can reuse those across the different workloads that are inside of Microsoft Fabric. So no longer do I have to copy data. We've just got one copy of the data. From my lakehouse perspective, I can be using notebooks to stage and get the data in the right place. I can take it, that same data, those same Delta files that are in the lakehouse or inside of one lake, I can stand that up inside of a warehouse. I can do what I need to do to provide transactional support, and I can even create tables directly from the warehouse that will persist inside of OneLake. And then I can take that into Power BI using the DirectLake capabilities and actually leverage those Delta files that are inside of OneLake. I didn't move any data. The data is just there. We can also take advantage of other things from a shortcut perspective, where we can actually leverage existing data that may be out there, whether it's in Azure Data Lake storage. What was also presented is this ability to actually go connect to Amazon S3 storage. Maybe your data is in Amazon cloud. So whether it's in a different cloud, whether it's Microsoft's Azure cloud or it's Amazon's cloud, or you know, maybe it's Google's cloud as well, these things will be available where you can just create that shortcut. You're not moving data. It's still where it was. And I can leverage that and create amazing reports in Power BI and or do my data science operations on top of that. These are all capabilities of Microsoft Fabric that it brings to the table for you. And what will be coming, it's not available as of the recording of this video yet, but it was highlighted at the Microsoft Build Conference, this inclusion of Copilot with inside of Microsoft Fabric across different areas. So Copilot with inside of notebooks, Copilot for Power BI. These things will help you leverage and get the most out of the product in an easy way. To get started with Microsoft Fabric, all you need to do is head over to fabric.microsoft.com and sign in and or sign up if you've not had an account already. If your organization's been leveraging Power BI, congratulations, you've already got Microsoft Fabric. They may need to turn that on from a tenant perspective, and or back that with capacity, but you'll have it available to you. And if you just want to try it and get started to see what it's all about, Microsoft Fabric comes with a free 60-day Fabric capacity that you can leverage so that you can start learning how to use Microsoft Fabric from lakehouses to warehouses, using all the notebooks and data flows. And as you get started in your journey, there's two places that I want to point you to right off the bat to begin your journey. The first is the Microsoft Fabric Learn content, where this will walk you through what it's all about. This is a great foundational set of information that can help you in your journey. And then also the end-to-end tutorials that will walk you through like how to create a lakehouse, how to create a warehouse to start you in your journey with sample data and get up and running quickly, leveraging that free 60-day Fabric capacity if that's all you have. And you can bet on the Guy in a Cube channel, we will continue to create great content for you to help you in that journey to learn Microsoft Fabric. And we will also have courses to help you go even deeper than what's available just on the YouTube videos. So welcome to the Microsoft Fabric family and community, inclusive of Power BI, of Synapse, of all of these things related to data. And this is really something that can help your organization take your data to the next level. For more great Fabric content, check out this playlist up above where we're going to add some great content to help get you started with Microsoft Fabric. As always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.